Hello everyone, it is Prashant Shah this time. I'm sorry, today AP is busy. He is in another meeting, so I am joining with Raghunath for options talk. This is 36th options talk, Raghunath, right?
Yes.
So good, 36 weeks we have been recording this. I hope you guys are liking it. Sorry, you have to bear with me today. I'll be talking about two things today. One is market trends, and another is a pattern which you can look for in any instrument to find better risk reward opportunities. So, coming to the market trend first, see, these are the price charts basically, maybe showing the same thing, but there are certain patterns which we can quickly have a look at. For example, this is a Heikkinen chart. We have series of bullish candles. This is candlestick chart, which is trading above this. These bands are Tonsian channel bands, and it is comfortable above upper band. And right now, the RSI is not at the previous peak, even though market is at new high. So kind of bearish divergence, which keeps on happening in strong trends as well. This is Renko chart here. It turned to it came back to these clouds, which is a difference. These clouds are moving average and super trend, and those are the perfect pullback spots. It is again back to upper band, above upper band. And this is point and figure chart. Here we have a strong bullish column, which is engulfing the previous bearish swing. There were 9 sessions here with for the bearish swing, and we have covered it in about 5 sessions. So these are the bullish counts which are open. Even in that correction, this count was this very bottom was protected. So that's a bullish thing. So right now trends are strong. Of course, non-multiple time frames. So it's a very bullish trend. We have seen these kind of things, in past as well. See, this was a strong bearish trend, engulfed by a strong bullish anchor column. The strong bullish column is what we call as anchor column, or strong bearish column is anchor column, which tells us about the strong trend in place. So we have seen that before also, and this happens in the strong bullish trends when there is a strong correction. And followed by a strong anchor column, or when previous the current column is completely engulfing the previous column, like bullish engulfing pattern in candlestick chart. We have similar thing in point and figure as well, but unlike candlestick here, this is a column which represents a swing. So a bullish swing is engulfing the previous bearish swing, is a pattern on this point and figure chart right now. We have So this black line is a moving average line, and these kind of patterns above moving average line tells us that there were that it is a pattern of trap. There was a strong correction and then immediately strong bullish column. So we have seen a trend of consolidating columns after those kind of pullbacks and strong anchor columns. So that can also be an opportunity, but right now we are in a very strong new territory, and those consolidation or correction will be an opportunity, I believe. So that's the pattern right now. Now on all price charts, the trend is strong and bullish. We don't have anything at left to look at the resistance, but I think I'll share my experience here. See, in strong trends in technicals, you have indicators, you have price patterns, but what is more important is to have a good idea about the trend in place. Whenever there is a strong trend in place, you should tweak your strategies accordingly. So when there's a strong trend, the supports are more rewarding than resistances. When there's a strong downtrend, you should look for the resistances than support. In strong uptrend, you should look for supports than resistances. They are more rewarding. Trading them is more profitable. And so what happens is, in strong trend, if you keep looking at top, there will be an occasion when price will fall suddenly from that level. But every now and then, trying to find the reversals will damage you more than the correction itself. That is the thing we have to keep in mind while looking at the chart. So right now what I see is there's a strong trend. Yeah, there can be exhaustion. So for example, this is a candlestick chart of Nifty. The below line is I'll use a simple breadth indicator which everyone can understand. For example, stocks trading above, let's say stocks trading above 20-day average in Nifty 50. So this is a candlestick chart, and this green line below is the number of stocks trading in Nifty 50 above 20-day moving average. So right now it is almost about 68% stocks are trading above 20-day average. Right, so this is a market breadth. When markets were bullish, when we saw the high last time of about 14,600, that time it was almost around about 80%. So 80% stocks were trading about 20-day average, and in the correction it almost went to 12%. So almost 90% stocks went below its short-term average. Now of course the correction was very sharp then, but it can be a very important indicator, right? When most of the stocks are participating in a strong uptrend, it is a bullish market. But almost every stock is in uptrend, it can be a sign of exhaustion. Right now, there is no such sign on the bread chart. Let's look at Nifty 500. So, number of stocks trading above 20-day moving average in Nifty 500 universe are about 60%. So it is kind of a stable market, a decent participation. It is less than the previous peak, but it is because of the correction that we, the sharp correction that we had in between. So right now it is a bullish case, and there is still a strong room for upside. Let us have a look at how many stocks are trading above 200-day moving average. So it is still about 90% stocks trading above 200-day moving average. It is a strong bull market. So as long as this picture is intact, these deeps are opportunities to participate. Let's have a look at swing-based breadth. So this is a point and figure chart. A breadth, it tells us how many stocks are trading in column of X on 1% box well in Nifty 500 universe. So it is it has turned from previous peak. It is kind of overbought zone. But what happens in a strong bull market is typically it is followed by time correction. So more of a consolidation than price correction. That could also be an opportunity. So we might see some kind of consolidation where stocks will turn to column of O and breadth chart will correct. So that is why we have to understand this trend of breadth based on the market phase. So right now we have to keep a strong trend in mind while deciding on the trading strategy. So this is a table where we can see breadth readings of different sectors. Let me show it as a chart. So you can see this bars for each sector. I'll quickly explain it. This blue bars are telling us number of stocks trading in a bullish swing in that particular sector. This gray bar is telling us how many stocks are trading above their previous swing highs. The green bar is telling us how many stocks are in bullish momentum in that sector, and orange bar is telling us how many stocks are trading in bearish momentum in that sector. Now I always try to go through this and just look at the size of the bars on different sectors. The tall bars mean strong trend, strong bullish trend if there's a strong blue bar. And strong blue and green bars means strong bullish trend and a strong momentum. Small bars and tall orange bars would mean strong bearish momentum. Right? So right now, of course, it is a strong bull market. We have tall blue bars almost everywhere. But relatively small blue bars means underperformance. Now, right now we have very strong numbers in bank index. Almost 90% stocks are in bullish swing, and almost 75% stocks are in strong bullish momentum. So these are very strong numbers. Same thing we see in cement stocks or in auto index and financial services or private bank index. Sectors like hotels and sugar are relatively performing weak, so they are kind of underperformers. Let me show another interesting thing quickly. We call this D sectors. So it takes three things into account: the performance of sector versus Nifty, the performance of sector versus other sectors, and trend of the index, the sector index. And we score the sector accordingly. And you can see it for short term, medium term, and long term. So what we should typically see is how a sector is behaving in medium term and how it is doing in short term. You can also see the reading of number of stocks in bullish swing or in bullish momentum in that particular sector. So two things I find very interesting here. One is banks, PSU bank, the private bank, or the financial services. These are very bullish in medium term, and they are very bullish in short term as well. So the correction here, because there is a kind of exhaustion in short term, but any correction here will be an opportunity or pullback opportunity. So anything which is doing good in medium term, if it corrects in short term, it is an opportunity. For example, IT index in medium term is relatively stable and bullish. It is underperforming in short term. Another interesting space is Realty Index, which is bullish, which has turned up in short term, and it is very bullish in long term and relatively stable in medium term as well. It was relatively stable when Nifty was correcting. So any sector which is showing strength in long term, the correction in short term is kind of opportunity. We can call it a rotation, you know, because okay, so what happens is you know, this kind of sector rotation we can see keep on happening in short term. So what happens is a sector that comes in the which is correcting in the short term, but it is if it is strong in the medium term or long term, that's the opportunity to participate. You know, that's a very important observation. So in relative strength, typically what we see is when markets are going up and the sectors which are not contributing are relatively weak, but actually when if the sector is leader or strong on a medium term or long term basis, and if it is not participating in short term, that could be an opportunity. You know, that is a part of sector rotation, and that could be an opportunity where we should look for pullback patterns in the stock of those sectors. Now, coming to pullback, I'll quickly share one important observation. So, see, this is a chart of Nifty that we were discussing. When there is a correction, when price comes to the moving average line, which the moving average and point and figure is, by the way, very fascinating concept. It is the average of swing. So, this is a 10 column average. It is average price of last 10 swings, basically. So that's a very interesting concept. When price turns or comes near to that moving average, like we see on the candlestick chart, price comes to moving average and it doesn't sustain and, you know, bounce back immediately. We call it rejection of the moving average. Similar concept is there on point and figure also. When it comes near moving average, it is a very interesting formation. And when it rejects that moving average, when it bounces back from that average, it's a very interesting opportunity. And what we need is we need confirmation. So basically, and when we are talking about option also, what happens is when the during strong when there's a breakout in a particular instrument, the premiums are usually high, and the risk reward may not be affordable. But when the price is correcting and we buy near the correction, the risk reward is usually affordable. So the thing is, there is a strong trend and then there is a correction, right? So strong trend can be defined as a double top buy or column of S, or there can be any other definition. And then there is a correction, which is kind of, you know, near particular, let's say, moving average. So when it is coming near moving average, followed by kind of, okay, so you need a confirmation here to buy. Usually your risk reward is very affordable. So here, when you buy and put a stop loss, you know, where your trend will turn negative, bearish, so that could be your very affordable opportunity. Your initial risk is relatively low and your reward could be high. So let me take an example here. See, this is a chart which is in a very strong bull market, bullish trend. There is a strong bullish trend on higher box values, right? So how do we trade this now? Whenever a stock is correcting, maybe a short-term correction, that could be an opportunity to participate, right? After strong trend, there is a shallow correction. There can be some short-term correction which is deep. So these are the places where we can look for an opportunity to participate. For example, this is a strong bullish trend, then there is a correction, right? There was a breakout as well. So how do we trade here? Maybe we can look for the reversal, price turning from O to X, and we can buy there and put a stop loss below this column of O. Same way, this was a bull market, there's a correction, because we don't know the length of this correction, right? So we need kind of confirmation to participate. Same way, this is a correction, and we can look for the opportunity or confirmation to participate in this pullback trade. See, this is a BEL. This also came to moving average, near moving average, and bounced back. So there was a strong breakout here and price corrected. So on a higher box value, stock is in bull market. This is a bullish breakout, right? There was a bullish breakout here as well. Now it is correcting. Now how do we trade? Maybe we can look for this kind of column reversal as a confirmation and put a stop loss below this. So one confirmation could be when price turns to the column of X. Another possibility is you go to the lower time frame, such as 0.25%, and see if price is trading near moving average. And if there is a breakout, or when price turns from that level, you can buy a double top buy and put a stop loss below O. So this pullback can be a good setup, which you can find in stocks. You can look when you can buy the options there, or you can apply some bullish option strategies, which Raghunath keeps talking about. Something like that. You can find some strategy in Opstra, and you can apply during pullback. Here I'll talk about the concept which is known as disparity. So you have a price which is trading above moving average, and this is a moving average level. So the difference between price and moving average is known as disparity. You know, so when disparity is high, that means the price is very far from the moving average, and when price is near moving average, that means the disparity is low. So let me just quickly plot the disparity index. See, this is a disparity index, right? This pink line is the zero line. When price is near moving average, the disparity index is near zero, and when price is above very far from the moving average, the disparity will be at high. Right. So how can we use this? Now let me explain a concept which I was talking about. For example, I'll show a chart like Bharti. See, this is a strong breakout. You know, if I go to the higher box value also, there's a strong breakout. Now what there was a strong breakout, price corrected near moving average and bound. So this is a pullback opportunity. We should look for this only when the breakout is strong. When your chart analysis is bullish, when you have a bullish view on the stock, this pullback opportunity is interesting. I have designed a scanner for this. If you go, I'll quickly explain that. So this is a scanner disparity index. So disparity is when price is trading near moving average. When the index is above 0.5, that means, what is the requirement here when we are designing this screener? This is moving average. Price should not be 0.50% above or 0.50% below from moving average. That's the requirement, right? So the condition here is disparity index above 0.05, minus 0.05, and it is below 0.05. So minus 0.05 below or above plus 0.05. You can have your own values here, but if you can, so if this scanner is built this way, the condition expression is 1 and 2. When both conditions are met, you can find the stocks which are trading between this band. So they are near moving average, and then we should look for the price pattern. So I'll quickly run this scanner on EOD time frame in F&O Universe. So we have these candidates. For example, Titan, it is trading near moving average. And if we get a buy signal from here, it will be affordable trade. Now overall, the trend is bullish, so this could be a pullback opportunity. Yeah, another is UPL. So it is coming, it is near moving average. Overall, there is a bullish trend. There's a strong breakout. There was a double top buy followed by a sharp correction, which is now near moving average. So we can quickly get candidates like this, and then we have to analyze a price chart. You can see this, there's a previous stock, and two O's are at the same level. This is known as a this is a concept of polarity. When there was a resistance which can become a support here, there is a probability that it will act as a support. The column reverse, if column reverses to X from here, it is a confirmation, and we get a opportunity to trade with a affordable stop loss. See this by MGL stock. Now there's a strong bullish trend and there's a correction. Now it went below moving average, it bounced back, and again now hovering around moving average. We need a confirmation. If price can turn from levels around this, that could be an opportunity with low risk for better reward. We have HDFC AMC also in the list. See, strong bullish trend, a deep correction. Now there is a kind of indication that price is trying to take support around these levels. See, it is also near previous high, which is like concept of polarity, and it is near moving average. So if you get a breakout after this, it in itself it would be a good opportunity to buy at pullback a stock which is in strong uptrend with relatively low risk. If we get double top buy from here, it will activate a mini bottom and activate this count as well. Last is SRF. So again, a strong trend, and it is kind of consolidation in short term. It is, this is anchor point, which shows us the most traded area during a move. So price bounced from near that area, and from moving average also, it is a low pole bullish pattern right now. So price turned from an important area and from moving average, and now again consolidating and hovering around that moving average level. If you get a buy from here, it will be a bounce from important areas, and that will be kind of confirmation. So again, giving us opportunity to participate with low risk. And if we get double top buy, these counts will get activated. So this was the discussion on pullback patterns. We talk about different strategies, right? There are momentum strategies which we look for in stocks, and there are breakouts which we look for. Pullback is also an interesting setup. There are many ways to look at it. This was There are patterns in Poinsot figure and Renko pullback patterns also. But this is an interesting concept of finding stocks in pullback. Vice versa is applicable for stocks trading in strong bearish trends also. This concept is applicable on all types of charting methods like candlestick. You can say run these scanners for candlestick chart also, on Renko also, on line break or Hakinashi as well. You know, so the idea is to look for the pullback during strong trends and find the price pattern there, which can give you good risk reward opportunity. That is all from my side. I'll hand it over to Raghunath now.
Thank you, Prashant. You have to make me presenter.
Okay.
Yeah, this is a very interesting concept that you have showed.
Yeah.
The disparity index.
Hmm.
To find the stocks which are coming to their moving average.
Hmm.
And so that you can look for those opportunities that you are talking about, you know.
Right. So you should look for. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, small correction in a strong uptrend. So you get opportunity to buy. Yeah, so you can use any bullish strategy. I mean, there are so many strategies there.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, this is a very interesting concept.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll take over from you.
Yeah, please, okay. Please, Ruben.
Okay, thank you. Hello, folks. You know, 2 weeks before, I talked about double diagonal spread, you know, what are the mechanics of this option strategy and everything, you know, how it is done and, you know, different, what is the role of Vega, what is the role of Theta and all those things. And I also talked about different adjustment methods that one could use. I didn't go into details of all these adjustments. And I said that I will do a simulation with one of the adjustment methods. Not all of the adjustment methods are listed here, but these are some of them. So today I will do one simulation where we could see these adjustments in action. So I will do this with December expiry and January expiry, where we do a double diagonal spread with December and January expiry. So we will start on November 27th, you know, the Friday before the expiry of the November expiry. We'll go to 3:20 p.m. where our adjustment period is. So basically here we are going to sell a triangle of front month options, which in this case is December expiry, and buy a out of the money triangle of the next month, which is the January expiry. So what we will do here is we buy a 20 delta, so sell a 20 delta December expiry. Yeah, here. So 12,500 put, and then on the call side also we sell close to 20 delta, a 13,600 call. Okay, so this is a triangle that we have for the front month, which in this case is a December expiry. Now we hedge this triangle, short triangle, with a long triangle out of the money to make it a double diagonal spread. So we go to January expiry. Yes, so January expiry. And then we buy an option whose price is closer to this 12,500 put in the case of put. So around 99 rupees. So 12,000 is the closest one, so we will buy that one. And in the same case with the call, which is around 50, 60. So we buy, yeah, 14,000 call. It's the closest to that one. So now we have this double diagonal spread, right? So if you go and look at Greeks, it's slightly long, but close to zero. And we have good enough theta. And it's also a long vega trade, which means if the volatility increases, then we are going to benefit from that strategy. Now, as usual, the max profit is around 8,000. So as usual, we take 50% of that as our target or stop loss. So now we will adjust when the short strike of the front month is threatened, either on the put side or on the call side. Then we'll do the adjustment. So we'll proceed further. So here you can see the bottom of the chart, the PNL as well as the gammas, gamma and other delta and other Greeks. Okay, we are fine. So for most part, no adjustment is required because we are within the range. So now we are first time we are seeing a negative PNL, and then also your position delta is too negative, right? So now we have to do the adjustment. Also, our short strike is threatened. So now we have to make an adjustment. So one of the adjustment was to make this into a calendar. So like, you know, to cover our short call here and then make into a calendar by shorting a 14,000 call of the December expiry. Right? Let's look what happens if you do that. So we cover this, the threatened strike, which in this case 13,600. And now we make this into a calendar, right? Now let's see what happens if we make that into a calendar. We go to December expiry. So we are making this double diagonal calendar on the call side to a normal call calendar. So 14,000 call we have to sell. Now, if I do that, what happens to the payoff chart? Now, as you can see, that the payoff chart is totally disturbed, and you don't no longer have that structure, double diagonal structure anymore. And your breakevens are far away, too far away, 14,397 from your current price. So maybe this strong adjustment is not needed in this case. So instead of going for a calendar spread, we can reduce the width of our diagonal spread. So instead of 14,000 call, shorting a 14,000 call, we will short a 13,800 call. Okay. We reduce the width from 400 points to 200 points, basically. So here, 13,800, we'll sell that one. Now let's see if we can still preserve the structure. Okay, this is fine. So we are still not able to preserve the structure, but we have some small, because this is sagging, the middle part is sagging and going below the zero level. So what we can do is that we have to move our put spread slightly closer to at the 1 standard deviation. Okay. So what we can do is that we cover our put as well here, which 21. Okay. as well as 12,000 put. Okay, so now so we can go with this 20 delta. Sorry. And we can go with this 12,900 call. Sorry, put 1 minute. Yes, so we short this one. And we'll buy a similar price or slightly lower than that. Or maybe this is too less. 12,900 is too less. What we will do is we'll go with maybe 13,000, yes. And then we buy something close to the similar price, 58, right? So buy something close to that. So 12,300 or 12,200, yeah. This should be good enough. Okay, so we moved our put spread as well to close to one standard deviation. So now this is how this adjusted calendar spread looks. So now we proceed further. Okay, we are in profit. Remember that the initial max profit was around 8,000, so target should be around 4,000, right? Now, just if you go back one day from 18 December, you can see that there was a big correction, and despite that correction, the put diagonal spread did pretty well. Because of the expansion of volatility. If you go back and look at the Greeks, okay, I go back to 18 December, it's 1946, and volatility is around 80 in here. And then I go here, and your volatility went to 23. So there is a volatility expansion. And because of that, because our trade is a long volatility trade, despite that, steep correction, we are able to withstand with our strategy. Okay, we proceed further. Okay. So at this point of time, we are already in profit or of, you know, reached our target. And I mean, we can proceed further and see what happens because you're still sitting comfortable. So at that point of time, our target is achieved, you know, it's still increasing. And so at this point of time, we also reached our time stop loss or time target, which is the last Monday of our expiry. So at this point of time, we should exit, you know, the profit is decent. Remember, our initial max profit was around 8,000 and we have more than 75% of that target has achieved. So at this point of time, we should exit this trade. So basically what we did is that we reduced the width of diagonal spread from by removing 13,600 call and then shorting a 13,800 call. So because of that, what has happened is that it has given us some more breathing room, and because of that movement, the on the put side, the curve went a bit saggy and went below zero. And to handle that part, what we have done is that we moved our put diagonal spread on the put side slightly closer to one standard deviation. Okay. And then we simply followed the method and we achieved the target of 75% of our max profit. So that is how we have adjusted and achieved our profit. And that's all from my side. So Prashant, if you have no questions, we can...
Raghunath, one thing that you told, that this was a brilliant thing actually, and very interesting, I believe, double diagonal thing. But one thing that you told, that there was a volatility expansion. So for this strategy, it is right. I mean, it makes sense.
It is good.
It is good. When you are deciding on a strategy, for example, in stock options, how do you think about this? For example, we can always think about this volatility cycle. I mean, the expansion will be followed by contraction, and we can perhaps design strategy accordingly. You know, probability of this volatility cycle. So if you see a pattern of expansion, then you design a particular strategy in Opstra. And when there is a pattern of contraction, then we anticipate the expansion. So I have one example, for example, Z Limited, which recently. So can I share my screen? Yeah. I'll show an example.
Yes.
Yeah, so now just see this chart. So this is, for me, this is a pattern of contraction. Yeah, for we call it triangle, basically, in Poynton figure. So every swing is within its previous swing. So this is a strong pattern of contraction, consolidation, triangle.
Okay.
So if we find this kind of, typically what happens is this kind of contraction will be followed by expansion.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So... And vice versa. You have this pattern of expansion, which is known as a broadening, right? So in technicals, we have these two things to define, like this is expansion and this is contraction. So this is contraction. So if you find stocks here, which strategy will you recommend to trade this expansion?
So in this case, for example, here there is a contraction and you are expecting that whether it go up or it could go down.
Yeah.
Because we don't know, I mean, which way stock is going to move.
Correct.
And we are also expecting, because there is a contraction, that the expansion will be huge. Right. So at this point of time, either one, you can buy a straddle. Because we don't know the direction. And or a strangle. We can do either of them. I mean, ideally, we could do calendars in this case, but because these stock options don't have the, you know, a good liquidity in the next month, it becomes slightly difficult to do calendar kind of strategies with the stock options. We could do this if similar kind of pattern would develop in Nifty or Bank Nifty, or maybe in Fin Nifty in future. Then you could do calendars for those kind of scenarios. But in these stocks, I mean, sadly, we are limited because of lack of liquidity in the, you know, next month, next months. So their choice is always to go with straddle or strangle in this case. Long straddle and long strangle. Because if you see, even with... Z Limited, the expansion was very huge after that.
It was very huge.
Yeah. after that
Mm.
consolidation in the triangle, there was a huge breakout expansion. So yeah, I mean, this is one good strategy. I mean,
Yes.
even with ATR, I think even with ATR or even with we can find this contraction in volatility, normal volatility, right?
Yes, yes, yes. You can do that using IV. You can use that using ATR.
Yes, exactly.
Contraction. Yeah. So, and another tool is price contraction, which we discussed in Z. We are using
yes.
point and figure as a tool there. So
yes.
we can scan for stocks in those triangle formation.
Yes.
For example, four column triangle. So you can scan for those stocks, and then we can look for buying straddle in those
or
stocks,
strangle.
Right?
Yes.
Or strangle. Yeah, and similarly, we can look for scanner like broadening pattern, which is a pattern for expansion, and we can look for writing straddle or strangle.
Straddle. Yes. So we are expecting some kind of consolidation. So yeah. Yeah, I mean that's a interesting way to go about choosing option strategies.
Right. All right, and when there's a pullback, recommend buying call spread or put spread.
Yes.
Right. So that could
yeah.
be traded if there's a pullback pattern in price.
Yes, exactly.
All right, Raghunath, we'll discuss this
okay.
some other time.
Thank you, Prashant.
Thanks.
Okay, guys. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.